After basic training, or during basic training, I got a furlough and came to L.A. and the talk of evacuation, so I helped my mother pack. And then I went to this Japanese school where we did our kendo and the Boy Scout meeting, and I see many people moving into the classrooms. And I says, what's going on here? I says, these are people from Terminal Island. They were booted out of there. They had no place to go, so they're here. So I said, hey, how come they were booted out? You know, that's when I started to think, hey, something is wrong here. And I think that's the first time my blood began to boil. I think even in the Army before that, I had no problem. Basic training, it was all mixed group. Well, I had a little ROTC, and the Boy Scouts, we have close order drills, so even the sergeant knew that, so he had me leading the whole platoon just a trainee, leading the platoon and all that. So I didn't feel any discrimination in the Army. Of course, later on, I applied for officer's training. Then I was told, you're not eligible. So I went for a non-com class to become a non-commissioned officer. But the slight indication of that, I said, I guess I am Japanese. So, I didn't blame anybody. I said, well, such is life, you know. But it was at the Terminal Island explosion, you might say, that's the first time I start to feel, hey, I was starting to get angry, you might say.